History Month. On the contribution from African Americans to the United States. It honors all Black people from all of U.S. history. And we celebrate here in the United States. President Ford is the one who officially recognized Black History Month. And we always celebrate during the month of February. So up first, we have our first preschool language contest, reading from Martin's Big Word and reciting lines from Change Thing.
This month we learned about leaders. We learned about how Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. was an important leader. These are some of our big words. I love fairness. Helping two people to love. And work and help and love. We like to be kind for friendship. Everyone loves to everyone. Friendship and love. Peace. Seattle.
Federación Escolar en Estados Unidos.
Buenos días, estudiantes, maestros. Leyeron un texto sobre la segregación escolar aquí en los Estados Unidos. Entonces ellos van a dar un resumen de lo que aprendieron o de lo que estudiaron. Gracias.
Muchos estudiantes afroamericanos con negros pelearon por sus derechos para asistir a las escuelas para estudiantes blancos. Ellos no tenían acceso a una buena educación. Las escuelas estaban segregadas, había escuela para niños blancos y escuelas para los negros. Las escuelas para estudiantes negros eran inferiores y tenían problemas. Por ejemplo, no recibían dinero para comprar materiales educativos. Los textos que leían eran usados y vendían en las escuelas para estudiantes blancos. Las leyes de Jim Crow decían que los niños blancos y los niños negros no podían asistir a la misma escuela. Los maestros blancos ganaban más dinero que los maestros negros. Los gobiernos daban dinero a las escuelas para blancos.
Linda Brown era una estudiante negra que caminaba lejos para llegar a su escuela. La escuela que le quedaba cerca era para niños blancos. Su padre trató de inscribirla en esa escuela, pero no la aceptaron por su raza. Su padre llevaron su caso a la Corte Suprema. En 1954 los jueces dijeron que la segregación era ilegal en las escuelas. Este caso se llamó Brown contra la Junta Directiva. Para cumplir con la nueva ley, 9 estudiantes afroamericanos fueron escogidos para asistir a la escuela secundaria en Little Rock, Arkansas. Cuando llegaron a la escuela, no fueron bien recibidos. Los manifestantes los patearon y los golpearon hasta les arrojaron ácido en la cara. El presidente Eisenhower mandó a los soldados para proteger a estos 9 estudiantes. Esos estudiantes resistieron y algunos de ellos lograron graduarse. La lucha contra la segregación continuó en otros estados. Ruby Bridges fue la primera estudiante en asistir a la escuela primaria William Franks, Nueva Orleans, en 1960. Ella tenía 6 años. Muchos padres blancos protestaron y no la querían en la escuela. Estos padres dejaron de enviar a sus hijos a la escuela. Ella siguió estudiando y logró terminar ese año. Por su valentía, ella ganó la lucha. Muchos estudiantes volvieron a la escuela. Ella no lo podía creer. Aún hay problemas por resolver, pero gracias a estos pocos jóvenes valientes, las puertas de las escuelas ahora están abiertas para todos.
Carter Jr. was seen at Trial Cooks. His parents were slaves. A boy who read newspapers, he worked all day long. School 4 months a year, father loved history. Without him, nothing. Earned a PhD, Harvard University, brave, strong, smart, and helpful.
Amanda Gorman, Miami Lee. Speech impediment, had learning difficulties, poet. Inauguration, youngest to perform. Writing and reciting poems, powerful speaker.
Louis Armstrong, by Greenwood. Famous trumpeter, central about the first one, loves, that's super. Nicknamed Sachmo, he was also an actor, known for a raspy voice, hosted a broadcast. His career took 5 decades, was a composer. Only 6 years old, Ruby Bridges, only 6 years old, walking through the seething crowd. David Norris went to a white school. Ruby created a path, her journey began. She was very brave, courage that shaped our future. Stand up, make a change.
Tears from her dark skin, you are pretty, said Mama. Born in Mexico, Black Panther actress.
Black Panther model, author of Sue.
Frederick Douglass by Elder. Born to slavery, there for 20 years, but escaped barely. Disguised himself as a sailor, he wanted it a failure. His white friends would give him books that, so that he could learn. After he escaped slavery, it was his turn to teach others, and was ready to discover. Became an ambassador, spoke out against racial inequality.
Rosa Parks, Edison, and the Indians sit there, go back to the back of the bus. Didn't he first see? I will remember we started a revolution from probably.
Oh Lloyd by Christian Brown. Unstoppable, first NBA, first Black player in 1955. Broke the color barrier. Nothing could stop him.
1985, Dr. Sam Raimi. River students explore space, black woman in space, complete her dream. She was determined to be able to learn that.
Lonnie Johnson, what a creative person, using scraps of metal to make genius ideas come to life. Rockets, Sonic's a robot, what invention made him the most popular, you ask? The Super Soaker, of course. Took an exam and failed. Did that stop him? Of course not. He was born determined. During parties he would study and engineer. Hey Lonnie, it's NASA. Could you help us make a lightweight backup power packing system? Sure. Ideas flowing through his head, that will work. Solutions flowing through his head all the time.
Shaking hands, saying how do you do? developed a huge glow today. According to an announcement, local business leaders have agreed to Dr. King's demands.
But the troubles here are far from over. A bomb has destroyed the home of Dr. King's brother.
And this just in, a show of support for the crusade, President Kennedy has just sent 3,000 federal troops to keep the peace.
This by Dr. King and President Kennedy's efforts. Several weeks later, four young black girls, including my friend Denise, were killed when someone walked a Sunday school. The price of freedom had been great, but as Dr. King predicted when the segregation ended in Birmingham, it began to crumble all across America.
En el lanzamiento de cohetes Centauri y también contribuyó en la generación de baterías para vehículos eléctricos híbridos. En la zona de San José, en California, en lo que se conoce como Silicon Valley, y fabricaban semiconductores, que eran los componentes que necesitaban las máquinas y las primeras computadoras.
Development Department, and he patented the integrated circuit that powered the company's semiconductors and helped develop what was, at the time, the world's fastest memory chip.
Exactamente. En su trabajo en el departamento de desarrollo de esta empresa, contribuyó y patentó el circuito integrado, que es un componente básico de los semiconductores. Y construyó el chip de memoria más rápido del momento. Esto no era fácil en esa época para alguien de color.
Is Evelyn Boyd Granville, and in 1949 she graduated from Yale with a PhD in mathematics. She was only the second black woman to earn such a credential from an American university.
Can you go back, please? Okay. Evelyn Boyd fue una programadora también de computadoras y la segunda mujer negra en conseguir un PhD, un doctorado en matemáticas. Se graduó en 1949 de la Universidad de Yale, aquí en New Haven, siendo, como hemos dicho antes, la segunda mujer negra en conseguir esta titulación.
After making history at Yale, this trailblazing mathematician inspired generations of future STEM students.
Tras haber hecho historia aquí en la Universidad de Yale, esta magnífica mujer, inspiró a futuros estudiantes de STEM, Science, Technology, Engineering, Mathematics, Ciencias, Tecnología, Ingeniería y Matemáticas.
Next is Clarence Skip Ellis, and he was Office Talk creator and icon-based GUI pioneer. When he completed his doctorate in 1969, Ellis became the first black person to earn a PhD in computer science. Dr. Ellis's career took him to Bell Labs, IBM, and Xerox.
El señor Clarence Skip Ellis ha sido el creador de OfficeTalk y algunos icon-based, pionero en la generación de programas generalistas basados en iconos y icon-based. Yeah. Cuando terminó su doctorado en la universidad en el año 69, se convirtió en la primera persona negra en tener un doctorado en ciencias de la computación, es decir, en informática. Y posteriormente su carrera profesional lo llevó a Bell Labs, IBM, IBM y Xerox.
From 1976 to 1984, he worked at the Palo Alto Research Center, leading a team that created OfficeTalk, the first program to use icons and the internet to allow for long-distance collaboration.
Pues desde el año 76 hasta el año 84, trabajó en el centro de investigación de Palo Alto, liderando el equipo que creó OfficeTalk. Es el primer programa que usa iconos y que en Internet nos permite la colaboración a distancia, trabajar desde la distancia.
We have Gladys West, who is a GPS technology pioneer, and GPS only existed because of two people, and that was in a Forbes magazine in 2021. So GPS exists because of Albert Einstein and Gladys West.
Gladys West fue una pionera del GPS. El GPS es Global Positioning System, el sistema que nos permite localizar cosas alrededor del mundo, alrededor del planeta Tierra. Y para que veáis la importancia que tuvo su trabajo, la revista Forbes la pone al nivel de Albert Einstein.
Dr. Gladys West was inducted into the Air Force Space and Missile Pioneers Hall of Fame during a ceremony in her honor at the Pentagon in Washington, D.C. on December 6th of 2018.
Exactamente. Su trabajo fue tan importante que aparece en el Hall of Fame de la Air Force Space and Missile Pioneers, el Hall of Fame de los pioneros de las fuerzas aéreas y misiles. Su trabajo fue reconocido por el Pentágono en 2018.
Roy Clay Sr. was the godfather of Silicon Valley. And after helping HP develop an early microcomputer, the godfather of Silicon Valley built a hub for the developing tech industry.
Bueno, Roy Clay quiso trabajar desde el principio en empresas que le negaron un puesto de trabajo por ser negro en ese momento, pero él insistió y tuvo un papel clave en Silicon Valley. Silicon Valley es donde se fabrican muchísimos componentes tecnológicos, está en California, y ayudó a la empresa HP, a Hewlett Packard, a desarrollar el primer microordenador y posteriormente a fundar empresas tecnológicas en California.
Clay was also a savvy investor, and he worked as a computer consultant for Kleiner Perkins Caulfield and Byers, which is one of the most influential Silicon Valley venture capital firms. And he funded Intel and Compaq.
Eso, como he dicho antes, su labor, aparte de técnica, fue también de inversión en empresas como Intel y Compaq en Silicon Valley.
Mark Dean was the developer of industry standard architecture and the IBM PC. In 1999, Dean and his engineering team developed the world's first 1 GHz microchip, allowing computers to perform 1 billion calculations a second.
Bueno, Mark Dean estudió también computer science, ciencias de la computación, y entre algunos de sus logros, de sus achievements, Mark Dean y su equipo fabricaron un 1 GHz microchip, un microchip capaz de hacer 1 billion de cálculos por segundo.
Dean spent more than 30 years at IBM. His record of accomplishment and innovation earned him an IBM Fellow recognition in 1996. He was the first black IBM employee to receive that honor.
Y por todo su trabajo durante 30 años en la empresa IBM de ordenadores y de máquinas de computación, recibió el honor de ser el primer empleado negro de la empresa en obtener el Fellow Recognition, reconocer su labor en el año 1996.
Marion Crope was the developer of Voice over Internet Protocol, and she was one of the unsung technologists of the 21st century. Is the Voice over Internet Protocol. It allows us to communicate verbally via the internet. It also makes texting and video call services like Zoom possible.
Marion Crope trabajó en empresas como AT&T y creo que actualmente en Google, y su aportación se basa en Voice over Internet Protocol, es decir, el poder mantener conversaciones de voz por Internet. Antiguamente esas conversaciones tenían que ser por cables. Y esto ha permitido, por ejemplo, el poder tener reuniones vía Zoom y cualquier otra aplicación parecida, el tener videollamadas. Eso antes no era posible. Y gracias a su trabajo, ahora es una realidad.
Her career started at Bell Labs, which is now AT&T, and she envisioned internet connections not only linking computers, but used for making reliable and high-quality cell phone calls possible.
Exactamente. Su carrera profesional empezó en lo que se llamaba Bell Labs, que actualmente es la compañía AT&T, y su visión era poder tener llamadas y comunicación de alta calidad, high quality, alta calidad.
John Henry Thompson was the creator of Lingual Programming Language, and if you've ever played an online video game, you owe no small amount of thanks to John Henry Thompson. After high school, he attended MIT and graduated in 1983 with a major in computer science and a minor in visual art. He landed a job at Lucasfilm.
Bueno, John Henry Thompson estudió computer science, estudió ciencias de la computación, pero también arte. Y de esa forma ha podido desarrollar videojuegos y ha podido desarrollar aplicaciones en las que la imagen juega una parte muy importante. De hecho, uno de sus primeros trabajos fue con Lucasfilm.
Radia Abebe was a researcher and co-founder of Black in All and Mechanism Design for Social Good. After graduating from high school, she arrived in Cambridge, Massachusetts to study mathematics at Harvard. And in 2016, she co-founded Mechanism Design for Social Good. A year later, she co-founded Black in All to share ideas, create opportunities for collaboration, and generally increase the number and presence of Black people in artificial intelligence. Oh, AI, not all.
Bueno, finalmente esta persona, Radiet Abebe, la conocemos por su aportación a la inteligencia artificial. La inteligencia artificial es el futuro realmente de la tecnología de la información. Ella estudió matemáticas en Harvard y fundó las empresas Next, please. Mechanism Design for Social Good y Black in AI, es decir, personas de color negro que tengan presencia en la inteligencia artificial. La inteligencia artificial es un intento de que las máquinas puedan aprender como aprendemos las personas, y eso seguramente va a ser el futuro no muy lejano, por lo cual su aportación para que también las personas de color estén representadas, pues tiene mucha importancia.
Thank you.
third grade through fifth grade was able to be named through there. So we're hoping 6, 7, and 8 will do the same, so we can continue having these. This month's theme is African heritage, so many of the classes put together presentations, and some people will be coming up to present, and some of the classes have videos. I'm not going to talk over anybody. What is African Heritage or Black History Month? Does anybody know about it? Betsy? If you're not going to take it seriously, we're not going to do it. Okay. Be respectful, or you won't be a part of the town meeting. So, Gen Z, what do we celebrate during Black History Month? Do you want to go to someone else? What do we celebrate during Black History Month? Okay, so we learned in school about a lot of different Black inventors and Black people in American history. So Black History Month was created to focus attention on contributions of African Americans to the United States and on our Black people from all periods of U.S. history, and it's celebrated in the United States. President Gerald Ford officially recognized Black History Month in his speech in 1976, and he urged people to seize the opportunity to honor the often neglected accomplishments of Black Americans in every area of endeavor throughout our history. And we always celebrate during the same month. We celebrate during February, which is why that theme for our town meeting this month. So because my kids have had to come to all of the town meetings, they want you guys to see their video that they made.
Sting like a bee. Don't count the days, make the days count. We can't be brave without fear. Silence is golden when you can't think of a good answer. The service you do for others is the rent you pay for your room here on Earth. All by Muhammad Ali.
Always go back in time if you want to move forward. By Snoop Dogg. I'm not saying I'm gonna change the world, but I guarantee that I will strike a brain that will change the world. By Tupac. I am what I am. You can like it or love it. By 50 Cent. History has shown us that courage can be contagious, and hope can take on a life of its own. By Michelle Obama.
Never be fearful about what you are doing when it's right. Each person must live their lives as a model for others. I would like to be remembered as a person who wanted to be free so other people would also be free. I knew someone had to take the first step when I got to be broken hearts.
Party for self-defense, and they want to share some information with you about it.
Resistance comes in many forms. Sometimes resistance comes from unlikely places as well. In the late 1960s, a group of young men and women in their teens and 20s formed the Black Panther Party for Self-Defense. This group founded itself on a set of principles, many of which are still things people are fighting for today. These are the Black Panther Party 10-point program, written October 15, 1966.
One. We want freedom, we want the power to determine the destiny of our Black community. We believe Black people will not be free until we are able to determine our own destiny. Two, we want full employment for our people.
We want an end to the robbery by the capitalists of our Black community. We believe that this racist government has robbed us, and now we are demanding the overdue debt of 40 acres and 2 mules. 40 acres and 2 mules were promised 100 years ago as restitution for slave labor and mass murder of Black people. We will accept the payment in currency, which will be distributed to our many communities.
We want decent housing fit for the shelter of human beings. We believe that if the landlords will not give decent housing to our Black community, then the housing and the land should be made into cooperatives so that our community, with government aid, can build and make decent housing for its people.
We want education for our people that exposes the true nature of this decadent American society. We want education that teaches us our true history and our role in the present day society. We believe in an educational system that will give to our people the knowledge of self. If a man does not have knowledge of himself and his position in society and the world, then he has little chance of relating to anything else.
We want all Black men to be exempt from military service. We believe that Black people should not be forced to fight in the military service to defend a racist government that does not protect us. We will not fight and kill other people of color in the world who like Black people and are being victimized by the white racist government of America.
We want an immediate end to police brutality and the murder of Black people. We believe we can end police brutality in our Black community by organizing Black self-defense groups that are dedicated to defending our Black community from racist police oppression and brutality. The Second Amendment to the Constitution of the United States gives the right to bear arms. We therefore believe that all Black people should arm themselves for self-defense. We want all black people when brought to trial to be tried in the court by a jury of their peer group or people from their black communities, as defined by the Constitution of the United States. The 14th Amendment of the U.S. Constitution gives a man a right to be tried by his peer group. A peer is a person from a similar economic, social, religious, geographical, environmental, historical, and racial background.
We want land, bread, housing, education, clothing, justice, and peace.
The Black Panthers, although controversial in their existence, were able to accomplish great feats in social justice during their short lifetime. The most recognizable being the creators of the free breakfast and lunch program, the United States government adopted and spread throughout the public school system. Many of us still enjoy it. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.
Montgomery bus boycott. She is mostly known for not giving up her seat on the bus. And she is known as the first lady of civil rights and the mother of the freedom movement. Up next, we have Dariel and Natalia.